welcome to Comcast Newsmakers. I'm Sabrina Register. We're in Vancouver, Washington today for the Association of Washington Cities annual convention. And joining me right now is Deanna Dawson, who is the new Executive Director of Suburban Cities Association. Deanna, thanks so much for coming on the program. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thanks for having me. It's great to be here.
You bet. For those who don't know, Suburban Cities Association, how long has it been around roughly, and what sort of things do you all do as an association?
Sure. Well, I like to say Suburban Cities Association might be the most influential group that your listeners have never heard of, because we're doing a lot. We've been around since the 70s, been in our current existence since about the 1990s, and basically we're a group that brings together all the cities in King County other than Seattle to make sure that those cities all have a voice in the political process. You know, King County is one of the biggest counties in the country. In fact, it's bigger than a lot of states by population.
Wow.
And but 90% or so of those people who live in King County live in cities. And most of those don't live in Seattle. And yet, I don't think people really grasp that. And individually, our cities, you know, our Rentons, our Redmonds, our Kirklands, or our Kents, they don't have a lot of a voice in the political process. So the Suburban Cities Association was founded to bring those cities together, to work on common goals, and really give a voice not just to the elected officials in those cities, but to the citizens who live in those cities.
These days, what are some of the issues or concerns or even the common goals? Talk about what some of the cities are talking about.
Sure. Well, I think that everybody's talking about the economy right now, right? And so that's a concern for cities. They're concerned both with their own finances and with the finances of their taxpayers and their citizens within the cities. Along those lines, one of the biggest issues that we're always dealing with is transportation funding. And so that's always a challenge, but it's a great forum to be able to bring people together and to make sure that even the smaller cities have good staffing. We have a lot of great policy analysts on our staff who come together and make sure that all those cities, again, have that voice and that they're at the table, that it's not just Seattle's needs and the more urban needs of the county that are being met, but that all the cities are being heard from.
You've been in the role for about 6 months. Now.
Right.
Too early to ask you about some of your goals?
Oh, no, not too early. I mean, I think that you have to go into an organization having some goals when you start. And, you know, I come from a background of both being a city official. I was actually a city council member up in Edmonds, but I also have a background as a lawyer. And I think one of the things that I like to think of is, you know, when you go to trial, nobody ends up very happy. So it's great to be able to work with King County, with Seattle, to bring people together to address challenges before they happen. And I think that's something we can be working on. I think we're really poised right now. We've got great relationships with Association of Washington Cities. Our treasurer from our board is going to be the new president of AWC this year, Don Gerrand. Fred Jarrett, the deputy county executive, was one of our founding members. And so we've got some good relationships there, and I think we can build on those to really make sure all the cities are being heard from.
One thing that you just told me prior to the interview,
right,
that something unique about the association, that people are coming together, they're kind of crossing party lines and not worrying about parties, and coming together for some regional solutions, something that maybe our state could take a cue from.
Absolutely. Well, you know, we always hear about the partisan gridlock in D.C. or in Olympia, and, you know, we're not really seeing that at the cities. I think that I could honestly tell you, most of our city officials, our mayors and our council members, I couldn't tell you what party they belong to, because they come together and they're working on coming up with regional solutions, not worrying about, you know, bickering on partisan issues. And that's part of what makes my job really exciting, is getting to work with those people who are getting down to business and getting things done.
So the suburban cities, any city under 200,000, correct?
Correct.
So you've got some really, really small cities, I would imagine, and then some kind of bumping up 200,000. We're almost out of time, but how do you kind of address both those? Because I would imagine they have some common goals or concerns, but then they also have something unique to them as well.
Right. And so one size doesn't fit all. What we're bringing to some of the smaller cities is not the same thing that we bring to the bigger cities. The bigger cities, they have a lot of staff, and so they don't necessarily need the policy work we do, but we bring people together to the table to make sure that they're all on the same page on issues, because sort of a rising tide raises all ships. And we also, along those lines, make sure that all those cities are coming together, because even the biggest of the cities other than Seattle can't really make a huge difference in the region unless they're coming together with their partners. So
some solidarity there.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, Deanna Dawson, thanks so much.
Thank
Executive
you.
Executive Director. Thanks for watching Comcast Newsmakers. Headline news at the top and bottom of the hour. Hope you can stay with us.